I first wanted to welcome everybody. Let me be the among the first to welcome you all and to congratulate you on your admission to the university. My name is Professor Wil Srubar. I'm a faculty member in the Department of Civil, Environmental, and Architectural Engineering here at the university. And I'm going to be talking to you today with Professor Abby Liel, specifically about our civil and architectural engineering degree programs. So first up, I'll be highlighting the architectural engineering program. And you may notice, we do have a number of highly ranked programs in the college. Architectural engineering is actually consistently ranked in the top 1 to 2 programs across in the country. The reason why it's not officially ranked is that for those of you who have sought out these programs, they're actually quite few and far between. There are only about 20 to 25 accredited architectural engineering programs in the country, and we consistently rank right up there at the very top. So really high quality, high caliber program. So I'll kind of go through a little bit of some FAQs. This is how we kind of structured our informational segment. So I answered the first one, who am I? I'm a faculty member in the program. So I teach courses for both undergraduate students and graduate students. So if you came to campus, you'd be taking courses from me. And so I'll talk first about architectural engineering and really define it, because a lot of folks aren't as familiar with that field. And so I'd like to start out the gates by defining, what architectural engineering really is. So archi is the application of engineering principles. So by that we mean math and physics explicitly to building design and construction. So architectural engineering is not necessarily architecture, although you do learn some principles of architecture, the design, form, function, space planning, et cetera, throughout the degree program. But really an architectural engineer loves math and science and really does love applying those principles to buildings. So an architectural engineer studies a number of different sub-disciplines. They study structural engineering, mechanical systems, electrical, lighting, and construction engineering. In the United States, we become licensed engineering professionals, which gives us, just like a medical doctor's license, a license to practice as an architectural engineer. We work across a number of different teams and disciplines with other engineers and with other architects. We work with architects all of the time, explicitly in the space of designing and constructing buildings. So archies, I mean, at the end of the day, we love buildings. That is our application space. And so if you really do love buildings, if you're drawn to buildings, then being an architectural engineer may be for you. When you think of some iconic buildings that have been built, usually there's an architect associated, really iconic name associated with that iconic piece of architecture. But I just wanted to dispel the myth that one architect builds these buildings. It's really architects, the teams of architects, and the teams of architectural engineers that have to come together to really realize all of these building projects. So like I said, when you come into the program, many folks do think that architectural engineering is really niche and it's really specialized, but in actuality, it is quite broad. So if you're really undecided about what engineering discipline to go into, archi is actually a good discipline because you're studying different disciplines that have to come together to make a building actually function well. So you're studying principles of structural engineering where you're trying to keep people safe. It's the bones of the building. You're studying mechanical engineering, so heating, ventilation, air conditioning, air quality. You're really trying to keep people comfortable and healthy. We do study principles of electrical engineering because we have to provide buildings with enough power for the buildings to operate. We do teach you how to construct buildings and really how to lead teams to construct buildings. So we don't give you a hammer and a nail and show you how to exactly go out there and build the building. What we're doing is we're giving you the skills to be able to manage teams, to build build buildings quickly and efficiently. And then we also teach our students principles of lighting and daylighting and how to use the natural light of the sun to limit, to really minimize the amount of energy we need to light spaces inside of buildings. You have the opportunity as an architectural engineer to focus in one of these core areas. And so you can imagine when a team comes together to design and construct a building, you really have to be able to function really well in teams. So we do teach you a lot of principles of really good teamwork and really good communication, so that we can come together and have these overarching objectives of, in the corners here, minimizing cost of the building, minimizing the energy that we use in building operations, minimize the amount of material and resources that we use, and really for our clients to maximize the profits so they can actually get a return on their investment in building the building. As part of the program, we teach you in a number of different styles. So we teach you in lecture-based courses from the get-go with our intro to architectural engineering class in freshman year. And usually that's the typical way in which we deliver course material, but we also get you into the architecture studio to be able to see and understand and participate in that design process to give you a hands-on experience so that you can better communicate with architects. And then at the very end of your degree program, you have this senior capstone design course where you come together with, again, a team of your classmates to build a building from scratch. We give you a blank piece of land, we give you some design rules, and you get to, from start to finish, design and building and ultimately present your design concept at the very end of the semester. You know, I get this question all the time, why should I choose architectural engineering? Why is it cool? Really, if in a career you want to save the environment, so save energy, if you want to save money for your client, and if you want to save resources and minimize impact on the environment, architectural engineers do that every day. We reduce health risks indoors. So people spend 90% of our time indoors. Nowadays, it's a little bit higher than that. We're always worried about indoor air quality and trying to minimize the health risks and for the folks inside of our buildings. Again, environmental impacts we're reducing. We also, if you want to reduce time in the office, we're always out visiting with clients, with architects. We're on job sites or on construction sites, monitoring the construction process to make sure that our buildings are built according to the way that we designed them. And really, if you want to impact lives daily, you know, we again spend 90% of our time indoors. And so every time we walk into a building, we trust that the architectural engineers who had a hand in designing that building did the right calculations. We trust our lives to them. And so it's a very impactful and meaningful career because you do impact lives daily. You know, besides courses, there's so many other things to do as an architectural engineering student, and this is actually very similar to the opportunities as a civil engineering student. So I did want to point out a couple of things. Some are course related, and then we'll talk a little bit about extracurriculars. So if you are undecided about architectural engineering or the architecture program at CU Boulder, which is our environmental design program, there are minors that you can get in both of those programs. So you can get a minor in architectural engineering by taking a series of 5 courses to give you some exposure to the breadth and depth of archi. The same is true with environmental design. I really want to highlight our extracurriculars. Boulder, the department here, the Civil, Environmental, and Architectural Engineering Department has such a spirit of service and extracurriculars. So in addition to student groups, professional student organizations like the Architectural Engineering Institute student chapter, there are ample opportunities for studying abroad, for getting hands-on design experience of actually building a building with the U.S. Solar Decathlon competition. And there's also opportunities to get involved in terms of research, undergraduate research in a laboratory where you're discovering something new, where you're creating a new material for the first time. In addition, our main job on the faculty and staff at CU is to really get you on your way to a successful career. So there are ample career fairs that are held throughout the year to match you with internships and jobs. There are what are called service learning opportunities where you are doing community service that is really meaningful. And many of these are actually international experiences. So Engineers Without Borders, fun fact, was founded here at the University of Colorado in the Department of Civil, Environmental, and Architectural Engineering. Bridges to Prosperity is a similar organization that builds footbridges for rural and developing countries. Habitat for Humanity, we all, I think, have heard about. And then I did mention study abroad and research opportunities. Many other opportunities, like I said, include professional organizations that link you to potential employers in the industry, and then ample opportunities to be involved in student design competitions throughout your time here at the university. Another question I get all the time, and I'm sure Abby Liel gets this as well, is how is Archi different than civil engineering? And so to talk a little bit more about civil engineering, I will invite Professor Liel to talk with you more about that.
Thanks so much. So I'm Professor Abby Liel. I've been on the faculty here for 12 years. And I actually teach courses in both architectural and civil engineering, which we'll get to in a second. But I'm going to tell you a little bit about civil engineering and our program here and some of the exciting opportunities that are available to you. Welcome. Thank you so much. We're sorry not to be able to welcome you in person this year, but we look forward to seeing you on campus sometime in the future. So I'll go to the next slide, please, Will. So I'm following a similar format. I'm going to talk about civil engineering and its subdisciplines. I'm going to talk a little bit about what your courses would look like, and a lot of that will be kind of, I'll talk about how it's similar or different from architectural and civil engineering, and then also talk about other opportunities available at the university. So I think probably many of you know, civil engineering is the oldest engineering discipline, right? You have heard stories of the Romans building aqueducts and pictures of the Eiffel Tower, right? We have a long history of building and advancements in buildings over the course of civilization. What I want to emphasize today is what civil engineering is in the modern world, right? So we are an old discipline. We are also a modern innovative discipline. So on this slide, I'm trying to show what civil engineers do. And they provide communities with safe structures, water and wastewater infrastructure, roads and bridges, wastewater treatment. Anything that you see built in our environment is something that a civil engineer has had a hand in. And I put a picture here of a community that is very important to me, the University of Colorado community. I live in Boulder. I work on campus. And everything you can see in this picture that is built by humans had a civil engineer involved. And the reason that I get really excited about civil engineering is just that the important role that these facilities and buildings play for our communities. Like, what would it be, what would our communities be like if we didn't have safe drinking water? Who monitors pollutants in streams? Who develops advancements in building technology so that we can have cleaner energy? A lot of those people are civil engineers, and maybe they're architectural engineers, right? But we're able to do so much for the communities we live and work in. And I think, you know, if anything from the current experience with this pandemic has taught us, it's that these advancements, you know, safe structures, access to clean drinking water, these are all things that are really important to our modern community. So I know I'm kind of running out of time, so I'm gonna try to speed up a bit. I'll go to the next slide, please, Will. But I also want to make the point that we're not like we're not still building the way the Romans built. And that's one of the really exciting things about civil engineering, right? So in this picture, we have a new material that Professor Srubar and some of his colleagues are working on. Can you go to the next slide? We also do some work in disaster resistant construction. So improving the quality of living quarters for people all around the world. So there's these kind of new and exciting things we're doing to be constantly striving to build better. Okay, I'll go to the next slide. Okay, so civil engineering is also made up of subdisciplines. Structural engineering and construction engineering are also subdisciplines of architectural engineering, but then civil engineering also includes water resources engineering and also geotechnical engineering. And these fields are the fields of engineering responsible for designing the built environment, constructing the built environment, and also maintaining the built environment. So in a modern world where our infrastructure is, you know, a really important part of what we're doing and there's constant demands for maintenance, civil engineers are integral to that whole process. And I'll just say here that our structural and construction engineering programs are quite tied together between architectural and civil engineering. The main difference is that architectural engineering focuses on buildings and civil engineering focuses on everything like dams and bridges in addition to buildings. But that said, if you end up in one and then you decide you want to do the other, it's not, you know, there's many opportunities to kind of change your mind or move back and forth or take courses in both disciplines. Could you go to the next one? No. So just a little bit about our curriculum, and this would be true, at least in the first years would be very similar for civil and architectural engineering. And those years are really about fundamentals. These are like the pillars in my table here. So there's a lot of science and math, physics, chemistry, computer science, calculus, linear algebra. That's what's gonna kind of lay the groundwork for your career in engineering. And then in both of our architectural and our civil engineering programs, we try to make sure that you get technical breadth and technical depth. So the breadth looks like, you know, if even if you're sure you want to do structural engineering, we ask you to take courses in water resources and in geotechnical engineering. Likewise, in architectural engineering, if you're sure you want to work on lighting, we ask you to take courses in the other things. And then if you do have or when you identify your focus, that's where the technical depth comes in. So if you are really passionate about water and water quantity and managing water demands in the western part of the US, which is very drought prone, then you would might want to focus on water resources, and that would be where your technical depth would come in. Okay, let's see, I'll go to the next one. Most of the things that Professor Srubar mentioned for enrichment opportunities are also available in civil engineering, practically probably all of them. Our students motivate and inspire me every day with the number of things that they are doing and the things that they are passionate about. This is bridges built, a pedestrian footbridge built by our undergraduate bridge building group, which is Bridges to Prosperity or Engineers in Action. Our students are volunteering to help communities get safer water, better water distribution systems, safer housing in Nepal and Peru and Guatemala. I mean, there's so many exciting opportunities to travel the world to do engineering. The study abroad program is bigger and more exciting and more targeted to the interests of engineering students every year. So I see so many students these days who are really able to fit that into an engineering curriculum. And then we really take our role seriously in helping students onto the path of the career that they are looking for. And so these professional organizations and career fairs and things like that are also a really important way of helping you get from the university setting to that career that you're really hoping for. And I think we can take some questions, and sorry, we kind of went over time a little bit.